Hello, the greatest Agatha Mind family. How are you all doing? Thank you so dearly for always supporting us. I really appreciate. If today the first time you are coming across this wonderful, great family, or you are seeing my face for the first time, I still remain your one and only Agatha Progress, and I bring it to you back to back. Remember, we react to all videos, and your opinion is highly needed. So let's dive into what is happening today, and I will be right back.
Zoo, Buhari's zoo. Yes, my people, I die. Africa cannot talk of integration when we cannot solve problems like the problem in Biafra, in Cameroon, and other places, Central African Republic, South Sudan. We must solve it now.
Yeah.
So the question of Biafra, the Biafrans are asking for referendum.
Yeah.
They say, my friend, since we gave you power, no airport, no school, no what, everything is gone. You leave London, you want to reach Lagos. You reach Lagos, you want to go home to your village. You take 4 days, yet you took only 8 hours from London up to Lagos. Have you seen the trouble that the Biafrans have?
Mm.
No airport. No good roads. The roads have a pothole. Not even a pothole anymore. It's a crater. It's gone down. The car disappears for 10 minutes, then it emerges because it is rolling down and up. There is no infrastructure in southern, southeast Nigeria. Pollution is of the highest. They drill oil, but they are not pumping in money back to the people. So these people have said enough is enough. You know, for us, we want African integration. But when we find a problem of Nigeria is real, that it must be discussed, they have decided, the Israelis are saying, they will protect Nnamdi Kanu. So you try them, try you. They will cause you a coup. So Buhari, be careful. That's all I can say today.
Yeah, I think the Biafrans and in this struggle, they're making some strides. Of course, with that assurance from Israel that they're going to provide security for Nnamdi Kanu, it means not necessarily him alone, but it means also protecting the struggle or even supporting the struggle, because mm-hmm. in essence, that is what they're trying to actually, the message they're passing across. So in what Buhari then has to do is just to accept and allow these people to have this referendum so that they can determine their fate. Mm-hmm. I suppose we have spoken so much. We have said a lot about the Biafra struggle. The only thing...
And then Jesus said, remove the stone. And when they removed the stone, now Jesus prayed. Listen, only Jesus prayed. Martha and Mary did not pray. The people around did not pray. Only Jesus prayed. The people's artwork was to remove stone, not to pray. What does it mean? Sometimes in Nigeria, those who should be praying are the ones looking for stone to remove. And those who should be removing stone are the ones praying. It does not work. Or what it means is that some prayers we do over certain situations is a waste of time. Jesus told them, remove the stone. He didn't tell you to pray. Remove the stone that is covering him. Your work is to remove the stone. He didn't tell them, cast and bind the stone out. Pray the stone out. Poverty in Nigeria cannot be cast. Cannot be cast out. It cannot be declared out. It cannot be delivered out. Poverty in Nigeria is caused by stone holding the people in the grave of poverty. And those stones are in the presidency, in National Assembly, in government houses. The Lord is telling us, remove them. Stop praying about them. Remove them. And how do you remove them? Remove them through election. When it's time for election, remove the ones that have not performed. And if you even make mistake and elect them, after 1 or 2 years, they are not performing. You can also remove them from peaceful protest. Occupy Aso Rock, occupy the National Assembly, occupy government houses until these stones that are holding people perpetually in poverty are removed. Jesus, God is saying, remove them. This is the mistake of religious people. You go, we go and gather people all the time from January to December, praying for job, for prosperity and breakthrough. Meanwhile, the people are supposed to be out there removing this stone. I think time has come when Khan, and then the body that is in charge of all Muslims, pastors, priests, bishops, religious leaders in Nigeria, time has come for us to organize one powerful crusade where both Christians and Muslims will come. And that crusade should take place in the Ego Square, in the National Assembly, in Asorok. Occupy the place. Bring the people out, everyone, let them go. And stay there, and the senators, and the members of House, and the president and ministers, let them go nowhere until they do certain things that they need to do. Or else, remove them. Make them to do what they're supposed to do, or else remove them. Time has come for us to do that. Let's stop every time gathering people to come and pray for breakthrough, whereas the stones have not been removed. Jesus did not remove the stone, no, and the people did not pray. So our positive actions sometimes are all that God needs. He will now do the miracle. We need to remove the stones in Nigeria, the stones that are blocking, or the stones that have held our people in the grave of penury, in the grave of poverty, in the grave of joblessness. I have told you where they are. It is time for Christians and Muslims to mobilize and go and remove those stones, irrespective of where they are, who they are, or where they are coming from. We just learned that senators took delivery of exotic cars that they ordered. A country that cannot, we don't even know how many centers where COVID-19 victims can be treated. But our senators broadcast worth billions of naira. The defense that they have brought is that they ordered for the car before the outbreak. This virus broke out since last year. When they even budgeted money for that car, everybody was shouting. They still did not hear us. They went and ordered. Oh, yeah, see them now. Money that would have been used to equip hospitals. Our leaders are using it to buy expensive cars. Where are they driving to? I don't know. Many of them are in Abuja. Their office is in Abuja. Where would they drive the jeeps to? Whether from our poor quarters to National Assembly. How many minutes? In U.S. with the largest economy. Senators rent houses. They pay for their houses. But in Nigeria, you give them houses, you give them cars, you give them furniture, allowance, and all of that. These are the stones, so let's remove them. Let's remove them. Let's keep religious, tribal sentiments aside. Remove these stones. I believe in prayer, but the Lord did not tell people around him. Jesus is like a pastor now, a priest now. This is crusade to raise the dead. He did not tell the people around him, start casting and binding this stone. He told them, remove the stone. We can make them to change some things. For instance, unbundle this concentration of power in one man's hand. Who says that the president must appoint INEC chairman? There should be a process that lands in the president table. What the president should do is to confirm after anybody who is selected has passed certain qualifications that is objective. Who said that the president should keep appointing inspector general of police? Why can't we have commissioners of police in each state? When it is time to appoint inspector general of police, let the best commissioner, which means the commissioner with the least crime rate in his own state that has overseen, be appointed inspector general of police. Why did presidents in Nigeria have to wake up, appoint anybody they want? They can appoint anybody they want. And sometimes when they do it, they retire those who are putting many years. Why can't we see these things? These are things that Nigerians should take action. These are stones you can remove. Block down, shut down government this thing until they sign all those things into paper. It's, but they don't need to debate in the house to do all that. There are many things that can be done by the action of the people. Once again, prayer is good though. When the people of Israel were fighting the Amalekites in the desert, they were not praying. Only Moses was praying. The rest were fighting. Religious leaders, pastors and priests, it is time to teach our people to take positive political action. Let's stop congregating people too much for prayer. Sunday worship or once in a weekend, this thing is enough. All this program for this, power pack this and all of that, from January to December, religious centers are packed and all of that and all of that. Let's take example from Jesus. These people should go and remove stones while we now stay and pray for them. When they remove the stone, see the prayer Jesus said, very simple prayer. Lazarus, come out. He said, Father, I thank you. I know you have always listened to me. But because of these people, that's why I'm asking you this. Lazarus, come out. He came out.
Oh my God, these are the type of teachings we want to hear. Buhari for now has not really known what he has caused himself. In fact, those readers in Nigeria, I don't call them leaders. I call them readers. They are readers. They are not yet leaders because you can see that the money spent on these people is more than what we take away poverty from Nigeria. But what do they know how to do? Is to cheat the people. We need to throw away those stones. Throw them away one after the other. How can you throw them away by supporting Biafra referendum? Because the way the thing is going right now, referendum must take place because the people are now wise. They don't want anymore. Because if you still remove them and you vote another person, they are also corrupt people. As far as it's the lineage, it's in their blood group, their genotype, everything. Oh, believe me, it will be so difficult to fight corruption in that country because they are born with it, ate with it. So people can no longer be wasting their time. That is why Biafra wants to go. Yes. When you be with these people for years, nothing happened. Year to year is the same thing they are doing. Then you need to draw the conclusion and say the marriage is no longer working. We just have to go because people are tired of talking. People are tired of complaining. For how long will this continue? So the only method now is for Biafra to go. Let everybody go. Duduwa on their own, Biafra on their own, and Nigeria on their own. Without violence and without quarrel, let's live peacefully. So my wonderful family, I just want you to drop your opinion for me in the comment section. What you feel about this video that you just watched, or about what you just heard from each of the horses' mouths. Drop it for me. I want to know. Thank you so dearly for always supporting this channel. I really appreciate it. I still remain your one and only Agatha Progress here on YouTube, bringing it to you live and direct. And if you have been following me, you have been hearing all this, watching all this, and getting all the necessary information, and you haven't subscribed, what are you waiting for? Please click on that red subscribe button that says subscribe and turn on the bell icon for more latest updates. See you when I see you. For now, bye.